The other big story in the news, another sad story that I'm not happy about, Edison Miranda. Wanted by the FBI for trafficking money in connection with drugs. And we know him, he trained you, he was a super cool dude, very friendly.
Unfortunate, again, there's a lot of peaks and valleys in this sport. This sport is a lonely sport. You know, when it's just you walking in the ring, there's a lot of demons that people deal with. You look at it time and time again. You have Johnny Tapia, you have, you know, you have, there's a lot of guys. You have Edison Miranda. You have a lot of guys that just, you know, come up on the short end of the stick. A lot of these guys came from poverty, so never had good guidance.
That's what I'm telling Ricky, that he grew up at 15. He was like homeless with no parents, that slept, ate out of the trash.
They had to figure it out. And sometimes it's hard to figure out, especially when you get into making the money that you're making. When you get into a certain amount of money, everything's new to you, because you got to remember, a lot of these guys came from poverty. So when they come into making some big dollars, you know, the world takes you by storm, and sometimes you're not knowledgeable enough to kind of, you know, maneuver your way around it and fall in the puddles.
By the way, last thing I want to bring up, Josito Lopez against Andre Berto. Tickets are already on sale. March 13th at Citizens Bank Arena in Ontario.
Uh-huh.
Break down the fight, and what do you think? It's a week after your fight. It's actually Friday. You fight on Saturday.
Yeah, it's a very, very competitive fight. Both guys have never been in a bad fight. Josito Lopez, you know what he brings to the table? He has a heart.
Hold on.
As big as the state of California, you have Andre Berto, who has a huge heart. Two competitive guys that are kind of at a crossroads, if you will, and they're going to leave it all on the line. So I think it's a great fight, a great matchup, and it's going to be a fun night of boxing.
Is that a message to your fans? Where could they follow you? You know what? That's the most important thing in this gym is the toilet paper.
Yeah.
Because if you have to go to a bathroom and there's no toilet paper, you're screwed.
Yeah, exactly. No, you can follow me at John Molina Jr. 135, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, John Molina Jr. And like I said, tune in for my fight, March 7th against Adrian Broner. Tune in for
NBC, free. You can't beat that.
NBC, if you got a television, you have a fight.
You don't have to stream it for free. It is free.
No, it is free. It's going to be and it's a very great competitive fight on the whole card. It's going to be good for the fans, good for the sport of boxing. I can't wait, again, to get back to you about Berto and Jose Lopez. That's a pick-em fight, man. It really is. People will say, oh, well, Berto's this, that, and the other. He's finished. But I think he's warming back up. I think he's ready. I think he realizes the importance of the magnitude of this fight. And I think that's going to bring more intrigue to the fight. So it's going to be good. And Josito Lopez, he wants to go out on top. Trust me.
There you have it. John Molina Jr. You can follow him on Twitter and Instagram. John Molina Jr. 135. Right here in camp. Getting ready for March 7th against Adrian Broner on NBC. EsNewsBoxing.com. I'm Melissa Kvack. Reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter.
At Setback.
And you can follow Johnny Funes.
At Team Funes.
At Team Funes. Why a team if it's just you? Shouldn't it be Johnny Funes?
Nah.
Okay.